relaxing unboxing video. I have a couple of parcels to get through in this video, and well, obviously by the title and the thumbnail you know what's in them, but basically recently I was thinking about it, and I really wanted to play some PlayStation 4 exclusive games that I hadn't had a chance to play due to my not owning a PlayStation 4. Then I got an email from a website that I've previously shopped with informing me of a big PlayStation sale, the Days of Play sale, I believe it was called. $20 about, and some big new releases about 40 to 50% off, so like God of War and Detroit. Yeah, they were massive discounts. So I was like, you know what, I really want to play these games. Let's get the games, and I can play it on my housemate's PlayStation 4. His hard drive was full, and I didn't really want to format one of my hard drives to be only used on a PlayStation 4 that I would, you know, not be able to use again. So I broadened my horizons and thought maybe I should find a PlayStation 4 that I wouldn't mind purchasing for myself. So, yeah, I ended up buying a PlayStation 4 and a bunch of exclusive games that were on sale. And, you know, I had that buyer's regret, buyer's remorse as soon as I paid for it. I was like, do I really need more games that I'm never going to get around to playing because I'm addicted to Overwatch? But I've been looking for some really good single-player games lately. So here we are. So I have three packages to open. Two little ones and a larger one. So let's start off with the smaller ones since they're in front of me on the desk. So it actually says Wii U Devil's Third, but that's definitely not what I bought. So assuming they just reused boxes, but I'll be upset if they haven't. Okay, that was a struggle and a half. But now we can open up our first box to see what goodies await. To me. Alright, so first up we have the new God of War. I love the God of War series. I got the Platinum Trophy for the first three games on the PlayStation 3. See if I can find them on the PlayStation 4 store, because I believe you can get them with like PlayStation Now or something. I'm not too familiar with how the PlayStation store sort of works. And there is a God of War 3 remaster, but if I can find a cheap copy of, I'll pick that up maybe. But let's finish the new ones first rather than buying a new copy of a game that I've previously played. So this is God of War. That's a back cover. Living as a man outside the shadow of the gods, Kratos, together with his son Atreus, must venture into the brutal Norse wilds and fight to fulfill a deeply personal quest. Discover an emotionally gripping tale of father and son. Journey to a dark elemental world of fearsome creatures. Conquer your foes in vicious close quarters combat. Something up here. Sort of a spiky gorilla looking fella over here. I was so keen to watch people play God of War, but I didn't want it to be spoiled for me because I figured one day it would go on sale and, you know, there'd be someone's PlayStation that I could borrow and I'd be able to play God of War on that. So yeah, this was a half price from new price basically. So I was pretty happy to pay for that. I don't like paying for games full price anymore because there's always a sale and you know, I think it's just ridiculous paying $80 or upwards. I probably don't even pay upwards of $60 anymore for games. Gotta wait for them sweet sales. So, next up, we have Until Dawn. And this one was very cheap because it's quite older. Like, I think it was almost a launch title, maybe, for the PS4. I really like this game. I've watched a playthrough of it. And I've played through about half of it myself with some friends. But I decided I'd like to play through it again and see what ending I personally get. So, the back cover. Only your choices determine who will survive. When 8 friends return to the isolated mountain lodge where 2 of their group disappeared exactly 1 year ago, things quickly turn sinister. Will you run from what's hunting you? Will you try to hide, or will you stand and fight? You'll have to make split-second decisions that will mean life or death for each member of the group. Play as each of the 8 friends, all of whom can live or die based on your decisions. See the impact of your choices and the path you've taken with the butterfly effect system. So this one is a sort of a story one where the choices you make obviously affect the outcome for each character. So, you know, it's kind of like a Telltale game. I think everyone's heard of this anyway. So yeah, happy to have that. And basically, I just got games that are basically PS4 exclusive. And I had no idea how many really good PS4 exclusives there were that I wanted to play that Xbox doesn't have, obviously, because it's exclusive, until I was looking at it seriously and like, I want to play all of these games. And you know, like, Xbox has Halo and Gears of War and State of Decay, though I think that's not exclusive to Xbox. I know it's definitely on PC, but I'm not sure if it's on PS4, but it's just like, their exclusives aren't that good compared to the PS4 ones. So, yeah, I was gonna save some money and basically just buy exclusive games on PS4 pretty much, with one exception so far. Next up we have Infamous Second Son. I also love the Infamous games and I got the Platinum Trophies for both of those as well on the PS3. And this one looks really nice. I have no idea what it's about though. I'm going in blind to a lot of these games, which is good because then I get to experience it for myself. So here's the back cover. I think the powers are a lot more about neon and smoke or something in this. Enjoy your power. Delson Rose's superhuman power is in your hands. Push your awesome abilities to the limit and see how your choices affect the city and the people around you. Hijack the powers of other superhumans. That sounds cool. Soar across the Seattle skyline and choose how your own story plays out. So again, it's one of those choose your own ending and choose your own path games. Bit more gameplay, like actual gameplay involved than Until Dawn though. So yeah, that one was also cheap being an older title. But I always really liked the Infamous games. The only part I didn't like was one of the trophies was for collecting all 200 or 300 shards, and there was no map to find them. You just had to go around and use this sonar ability to see if there was any around you, and that took forever. But next up we have Detroit Become Human by Quantic Dream, who made Heavy Rain and Beyond Two Souls. And this is a very new release that you've probably heard a lot about. Again, it's one of those choose your path, choose your story, and your actions games. And I have very little idea what this one's actually about. I know that it's about robots and slaves, and that's about it. So I'm pretty keen to play this. That's the back cover. Looks like we have three sort of main characters here. How far will you go to be free? Detroit, 2038. Lifelike androids have replaced the human workforce. They never tire, disobey, or say no. Which would be disobeying if you ask me, but whatever. Until something changes. Some of them have started to behave irrationally, as if they were feeling emotions. Tell your own story. Every choice has a consequence. Take control of three androids in their quest to discover who they really are. Face moral dilemmas and make life or death decisions. So yeah, that's Detroit. I loved Heavy Rain. Heavy Rain is probably one of my favorite PlayStation games ever. Beyond Two Souls was okay, but definitely not in the same realm as Heavy Rain. So I think in order of how good they are, from worst to best, apparently it's Beyond Two Souls, then Heavy Rain, then Detroit. But I haven't played Detroit, so, you know, Heavy Rain's my top at the moment. But it won't be hard for this to be better than Beyond Two Souls, because that just felt a lot more linear. So yeah, like God of War and Detroit, I'm thinking about streaming, because they should be fun. And lastly from this package is Horizon Zero Dawn, the complete edition. I have very little idea what this game is about. I know it's about, you know, fighting robots and technology and stuff, as like a primitive sort of hunter. I've heard nothing but amazing things about it from some very trusted sources, and when I saw the complete edition, I was like, you know what, I think I'll be pretty happy to play this. So here's the back cover. And it says, hunt deadly machines on a quest to discover your destiny in the critically acclaimed hit Horizon Zero Dawn and the epic expansion The Frozen Wilds. So I think because I got the complete edition, it wouldn't have the game blurb like the normal edition would. But it includes Horizon Zero Dawn and The Frozen Wilds, some extra items and weapons and costumes, it looks like, and a digital art book and a PS4 theme. So that's pretty cool. I sort of like that third person hunting, sort of like, I guess, kind of Tomb Raider-y gameplay. get the Game of the Year edition or the complete edition where I can, because even if I might not play all the DLC, I still like to have the whole thing and like the choice to play the DLC. So I don't, you know, get it and then have to go back later and pay more to keep playing. I just get the complete edition. So this wasn't too much. This was also pretty cheap. So, yeah, all those were on massive sale, so I saved a whole lot of money buying all of them. And I'm keen to get into them, basically. I think I'm going to play God of War first, because that's my absolute, like, I've been looking forward to that for ages. Alright, next up we have a thin package. There's only one item in this one. So let's crack it open. This one looks a bit more difficult to open, actually. Alright, so it's open. It's a very inconvenient shaped package. And, not the best condition of case here. Stickers on it, so I'm going to peel those off real quick. I don't like shopping at this place that I got these games from, because they usually gouge their prices a bit, or more like gouge our wallets, I guess, with high prices. But it, unfortunately, this title wasn't available at the other places that I was purchasing from. So, I kind of had to suck it up and patronize this place that I don't particularly like shopping from. But I picked up the Heavy Rain and Beyond Two Souls collection for PlayStation 4, because I actually really do enjoy Heavy Rain, and it'll be good to be able to play it on next-gen graphics and all that. So these two are also from Quantic Dream, who made Detroit. So here's the back cover with the two blurbs for both games. Your actions and decisions create the stories in two incredible adventures. Lead the hunt for a serial killer in Heavy Rain, and experience an extraordinary life in Beyond Two Souls. Heavy Rain. Discover how far you'll go to save someone you love. Explore multiple plot routes shaped by your choices. Play as four characters with different stories and skills. Beyond Two Souls. Embark on an emotional journey starring Alan Page and Willem Dafoe. Prepare for a psychological challenge packed with unexpected twists. Wield strange powers to affect the world around you. So yeah, I wasn't a huge fan of Beyond Two Souls, but Heavy Rain makes this collection worth it, and this was also on sale. Which is good, because if it wasn't, I wouldn't have bought it from this place, because their prices was ridiculous, basically. And I kind of want to fix this cover a little bit, but there's a little hole here in the cover, which I won't be able to fix anyway, because it's actually in the paper bit behind it. Yeah, I'll see how I go. So that was the second package, and I do actually still have a package coming, but not for a little while. So I kind of wanted to film this tonight. I also ordered Bloodborne from the same place as Heavy Rain Beyond Two Souls, the Bloodborne like complete collection or Game of the Year edition or whatever, because I love the Dark Souls games, and Bloodborne seems fantastic. I love that sort of, you know, flintlock pistols and all that kind of thing, and Victorian, esque themes, I guess. So I was pretty happy to pick that one up as well. So that's still coming, I think. I'm gonna gonna play God of War and then Bloodborne, because I know the others will take a fair bit of time. Let's have a look. God of War. Yeah, God of War and then Bloodborne, I think. So lastly, the piece de resistance. Big boy to open. There's going to be no quiet way of doing this, so bear with me. So I have a couple more games to show that came with this, but this is the PlayStation 4 model that I decided to buy. It's the PlayStation 4 Days of Play Limited Edition. So it has a 500GB hard drive. It's a slim model, and you should be able to see, yeah, it's blue and has gold embellishments. Instead of the normal one, and the controllers are deeper blue with the gold embellishments on the controllers as well. PSVR ready, but I'm not going to get more VR. HDR, so I think that's for like, that's a 4K feature, maybe. I don't really have a 4K TV at the moment though, so it's not really a big deal to me. Show on the back, so I was pretty happy with this. It was between this, because it comes with an extra controller, or a PS4 Pro, which comes with one controller but a terabyte hard drive, and you know, the ability to play 4K games. But then I was like, you know what, I didn't get the PS4 to play games with high graphics, because if I wanted to do that, I'd just play them on PC. You know, exclusives aside. So I decided to save a bit of money and get a free controller with it. And like most of the 4K games I looked up were ones that I probably wasn't going to play anyway, like a lot of Call of Duty and Battlefield and that kind of thing. Some of these new games do, but I don't really need to see them in 4K. So I was much happier to get, save a bit of money and get a free controller. I obviously haven't set it up yet, so I look forward to doing that on the weekend. And I might open it up after this and we can have a look at it and the controllers. But first, the last couple of games. I got Shadow of the Colossus. I never played this on PlayStation 2, but the idea always interested me. Then I got it on PS3, but for whatever reason didn't end up playing it. And, you know, I was really interested in... I don't like firing up my PS3 these days just because it's so slow and the controllers are all, like, on their way out, gunked up and, you know, broken. And that's not from, like, neglect or anything, that's just from playing it so much. So I got it on this, and this was also like super cheap as well, because it's older, I guess. So this is the back cover. The adventure that defined a generation. It is said, in a forbidden land at the world's end, the power exists to return the souls of the dead, but such power comes at a cost. A timeless classic. Live the adventure that defined a generation, masterfully remade with stunning visuals, enhanced performance, and intuitive new controls. So this is a remake and not a remaster like the other copy I have, so that's fine. That's good. An iconic tale. Explore seamlessly blending tense puzzle solving and unforgettable action. A colossal task. Face 16 majestic creatures in breathtaking combat, each battle more challenging and awe-inspiring than the last. So yeah, basically this one's all about climbing on giant beasties and finding ways to kill them. And I just really love how it looks, and I'm excited to play that one. Maybe I'll start with that one, because it might be quicker than God of War. But yeah, keen to play that. Then, I mentioned my love for Dark Souls earlier. I got Nioh, which is a bit like Dark Souls. It's a bit more fast-paced, and it's more like a samurai ninja themed than medieval and fantasy. So that's the back cover. Only in death will you find the way of the samurai. Ready your blade for the countless battles of a land torn apart by civil war. Clash steel with fierce samurai and fallen warriors. Stand alone against vicious demons. Master combat and find honor in every hard-fought victory. So I think there's, a lot of fast, demon and samurai fighting in this. Seems really cool. And that one was really cheap as well. I thought it was a bit newer, but apparently not. And there is, of course, a Nioh Complete Edition, but it's digital only, so I was very upset to hear that. Because I prefer to have games that I'm going to keep. No, hang on, that doesn't make sense. I don't know, I just like having physical copies over digital where I can help it. So the last game I got isn't a PS4 exclusive, but it was on sale. So when I got it with the other ones, it became cheaper again. It's Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. And basically this is kind of Battlefield, like you have class roles and stuff, but with a Plants vs. Zombies skin, a game which I very much enjoyed. So that's the back cover. The Battle for Somburbia. 100 plus playable characters to collect. Bring on the battle in 24 player online multiplayer. 2-4 player co-op modes. Your personal play Plants vs. Zombies playground. Solo play and split screen. I always wanted to play the first one. But I don't think there was a very good split screen or single player. So when I looked up reviews of the second one and they said that they had vastly improved on everything that the first one did, I decided that maybe I'll get a cheap copy of the second one. So yeah, I kind of just wanted like a goofy muck around shooter to play. So I'm not sure how that one will go. All else fails, I'll just drain it towards something else. But yeah, let's cut the camera and have a look at some of these controllers and PlayStation and the PlayStation body. It's a very nice blue. The controller feels really good. So I guess this is the front here, with a disk drive and stuff. Yeah, it's got a tiny little power and eject button there. And, now you won't be able to see it. PS4. I guess it would be this way. Thumbprints all over it because it's such a glossy surface. That's going to get annoying. I think I might invest in a vertical stand for it. Just so it takes up less room. But I think that about wraps up this video. So I'm pretty keen to go and get started on setting up and